Mom said we can have the computer all to ourselves.
We need a beat. Surprise! We were behind that video the whole time, and the music is not playing anymore. But welcome! Welcome all, welcome everybody to The Screen Is Yours! The second Eastwood Virtual Coffee House. It's so good to have you all here. We have a wonderful show ahead of us. It's going to be really good. We got 40 submissions of very talented Eastwood artists and some other family members in there too. And it's so good to have you all here. It's going to be such a wonderful show. And yeah, I think we just got to, first of all, if you don't know who we are, let's introduce ourselves. We are your MCs of the night. My name is Sidney.
I'm Caitlin.
I'm Megan.
I'm Megan number two.
Yes, and we are your MCs of the night. And we're just going to have a great time. We're going to watch a bunch of acts together. We're going to vibe. We're going to jump right into it because we have 40 acts to go. Let's get things started.
All right. So our first two acts of the night are going to be brought to you by, well, one of them is The Fruit Flies, and they will be performing Here Comes the Sun by the Beatles. And also, if you want some more of their wonderful music, check them out on Instagram. The link is in the description. And after Fruit Flies, we'll have Dylan Thomson doing a short abstract film called Rinse, Dry, Repeat.
Awesome.
Little darling, I feel that ice is slowly melting.
are you? Every morning he got up, dreading each moment he had to be awake. He'd look at the floor and scribble on gum wrappers. He never found a better way to joke around. The clock would tick and time went slow, and there wasn't anywhere he wouldn't go to avoid having to see anyone. He'd sit in a chair, he'd lean against a wall, it just didn't seem to matter much at all. But late at night, he had a savior in his sleep, in his dreams. She came to him and she said, poor you, poor you. No one understands you, poor you, poor you. And every word that everyone would say got mumbled up in his head, like mumble jumble, and everywhere he went, it seemed everyone was saying to him, blah, blah, blah. But late at night, he had a mistress in his dream, in his sleep, and she would say, poor you, poor you, no one understands you.
Hey, I thought the video was over. It was really great, but I'm really sorry I skipped the end.
And all of it.
So sorry. I'm sorry, okay. Dylan.
Anyways, yeah, it was really great. I loved how you incorporated dance with your music. And Dylan, I know from what we saw of your video, your visual effects were always really nice. I had watched the whole video beforehand, and I assure you, it was really great. And as pointed out by Jake Evans Whitley, Megan has bested Jane in battle and assumed her role seamlessly. Yes, we have Megan now. And she is here, yeah. And she's
never
seen.
Jane couldn't make it because of her injuries in battle, but she's doing well. She's doing well. Let's keep on moving, shall we? And I'll make sure to play the whole video next time and not get anxious and stop it so soon. All right, so next up, guys, we have Kate, and she'll be singing an original song about the pandemic and strumming the guitar, which is really awesome. And then after that, we have Maia, and she'll be drawing some mushrooms, drinking some tea, laying down in the grass. It's a nice time lapse. So let's just jump right into it, shall we? Let's go.
Hi, everybody. My name is Kate Figueria, and I wrote this song for all the people who are stuck at home at quarantine with their families, and that might not be the best place for them to be. And so this is for you guys, and I hope you like it. I'm supposed to do my homework. Why doesn't my homework? I feel like I have angels in my eyes, but I rarely pray to God. Must be the devil in disguise. And she is never happy. I cannot make her happy. Everything is always at a halt, out of my control, but all my fault. So I'm waiting for when to happen, and I'm blaming all my wasted time on her. She'll never love me the way she used to, so I refuse to love her in return, and she's angry with me always. Every waking moment spent on what I've done, I feel alone now, I need a home now, especially since I already have one. I was supposed to keep my secrets. Doesn't everyone have secrets? And it was violent when she took them. Nothing was the same, and I was quiet when she took them. And he was never meant to listen. and I tried everything I could, so that even if he heard us through the floorboards, the one thing I could stop is if he looked. So I'm waiting for when to happen, and I'm blaming all my wasted time on her. She'll never love me the way she used to, so I refuse to love her in return, and she's angry with me. Always, every waking moment spent on what I've done, I feel alone now, I need a home now, especially since I already have one. I hope you guys like that. I have to sneeze really bad, so I'm gonna end this kind of abruptly. I'm like literally holding on for dear life. So, have a wonderful night.
Wonderful job. Kate, thank you so much. Your voice.
Wonderful
so,
job.
So soothing. I love it. And we ran into another technical difficulty, and I'm terribly sorry, Maia. I edited the video in there, and then when I exported it, it did not show up for some reason. And I'm sorry about the technical difficulties. So at this point in time, we can't show it, but I will link it in the description right after the show for anyone who is interested in seeing it. It's a very beautiful time lapse of her drawing some mushrooms with some nice music. Sorry for the technical difficulty, guys. We're gonna get through this show alive. Let's move on to the next act, and all the other ones are gonna run super smoothly.
So next up, we have Blythe singing Your Mother Should Know by the Beatles. And then we have Teagan reenacting A Little House on the Prairie, which we would like you to know was recorded before the pandemic.
Let's all get up and dance to a song that was a hit before your mother was born. Though she was born a long, long time ago, your mother should know. Oh, your mother should know. Oh, sing it again. Let's all get up.
Your mother should know.
but you got him to walk. I don't know how.
I only let him carry a bit more lightly. He really is a gentle horse inside.
My tree claim.
Well, I love trees. Trees, trees, trees of all kinds.
They grow on these plains that have done it themselves before now.
I'm a cottonwood. Trees are the best.
Mm.
It is hard to imagine these prairies wooded, though.
I know, but the experts have mapped it all out, from Canada to Indian Territory, where the trees ought to be. And if half of them live, they'll seed the whole land and turn it into forest, like the woods back east.
Well,
then, time will show.
He will keep them alive if anyone can. Yes, I have utter faith in you too. I believe you could turn the desert into a jungle. I do miss getting my hands wet.
Don't you help on your boss farm?
She's a respectful lady, born in this country. She can't.
Why not?
It isn't done. What ideas you have. Well, I think we should walk down to the lake. Didn't you say there's a path to fill the water?
Yes. Wish I thought to bring a picnic. Shall we come out again next Sunday?
Yes! Will you join us again next week?
I don't think so. The buggy is a bit snug for three.
There's still room for you, Laura.
If the two of you are riding, you needn't come for me. I will be busy anyway. Mary's finally coming home.
Oh, guys, that was wonderful. Blythe, I really love the Beatles, and that was like, you have a heavenly voice. And Teagan, Little House on the Prairie, is also a classic, so good job on that. Quick note, after intermission, we will be replaying the two videos that got interrupted slash lost, so Dylan's video as well as Maya's video. Those will be after intermission, so we're sorry about that.
Cool. Next up, we've got Maia at, singing a cover of Cat Stevens's The Wind. That's going to be super sick. And then we've got a speed drawing that Paige did. And that's going to be awesome. There we go. Cool. That was so good. Oh my gosh. Okay. First, well, I guess second, whatever. The horse was so good. There were so many details in the color and also all of the rest of it. And I just can't imagine being able to do any of that. Wow. Great job. And Maia, your voice is so pretty. And the rest of you and your voice is so great. Well done, both of you.
Yeah.
What's next?
And now we have our very own Sidney Heemstra. He's going to be singing and playing the ukulele, and he's going to be singing a little song called Can't Help Falling in Love. And then after, we have A. Stewart, and they have a little stop-motion animation called Red versus Blue.
Here we go. Only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you. Shall I stay? Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in love with you? Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. Take my hand, take my whole life too, 'cause I can't help falling in love with you. Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. Take my hand, take my whole life too, 'cause I can't help falling in love with you, 'cause I can't help falling in love with you. Thank you.
Yeah.
There we go.
That was so good. Oh my goodness, Sidney, when all the little harmonies, all the little U's started popping up, that blew my mind. That was so good. And A, like, that animation, I think you're going to go places. You're going to go places.
Places.
Yeah.
All right, my good folks. It's time to move on to our next act. We got Emma Douglas and Kate Gayman, and they will be singing For Good from the musical Wicked. I love that song. Such a good song. It's a great, great song. And then after that, we will be seeing a snippet from Taylor Mann's short film, God Can't See Me When My Eyes Are Closed. Now, this is only a snippet of her short film because her short film is a little crazy. How do you describe it? Crazy.
PG plus.
What was that?
PG plus.
PG plus. So only watch it if you're 13 years or older. And let's jump right into it. Enjoy the acts, guys.
I've heard it said that people come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most to grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes the sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, I have been changed for good.
It well may be that we will never meet again in this lifetime. So let me say before we part, so much of me is made of what I learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart. And now, whatever way our stories end, I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind off the sea, like a seed dropped by a skybird in a distant wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, I have been changed for good. Just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame me for.
But then I guess we know there's blame to share, and none of it seems to matter anymore. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes the sun,
like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better?
I do believe I haven't changed for the better. And because I knew you,
because I knew you, because for
God. In the lust of their hearts, to dishonor their bodies among themselves, who exchanged the truth of God for the lie, and worshipped and served the creature rather than the Creator, who is blessed forever. Amen.
Lovely job, lovely job. Oh, your voices, Emma and Kate, they're just so, I love it, I love it. They're so relaxing and just powerful and everything. I love them, they're great. And Taylor, my goodness, those shots that like so beautifully crafted and thought out. If you wanna see what happens next to Parker, is he gonna put on more underwear? I don't know. You'll have to find out in the link in the description below, because if you want to feel all whoa, watch her video. It's very great.
Yeah. And some other sick videos that you can watch, we're going to show you. So next up we have On a Date, an original song written by Cody Holdershaw, followed up as well as a music video. Followed up by a cover of Ave Maria from Ariana.
Here we go. So.
Go out on a date, out on the town, my way far from now. No, you don't wanna spend the night with me, but I hope you can see that it's right, just you and me. You don't wanna go, I want you to. I think you'll enjoy, but you insist you won't, cause you found someone else that loves you more than me. But I doubt it. But will you please come with me? Oh yeah, I want you, and you know you secretly want me. Take you out on the field, we'll go for a night walk and see the stars and everything else in the world. You said you don't want me, but I know it's not the truth. I can see it in your eyes, you look at me, and then you say you don't want me, but then you left and roll your eyes, but it's so true. But I can do, I don't know what to say. I know you want me just like I want you, but you're caught up with some other dude. He may look better than me, but I'm sure his personality ain't nothing like mine, dear. Nobody will ever love you the way I love you. You're everything I want, you're everything I need, everything I've looked for, you're everything. You're more than I could imagine anyone would want, except that random dude, he's kinda rude. I know we're in love, you just don't know you're in love with me. I think you are, because the way you look at me, and in your eyes you look away, and then you roll them back, and then you blush, and then you wanna lay on my chest, and oh my god, I love you, it's insane, oh. You're wonderful, beautiful, everything I could ever imagine. I think I'm the one for you, and you're the one for me, just you and me, just wait and see.
So many different ways out of the dark, and so many.
There we go. The border disappeared for a second.
Wow. Those were two separate and sick performances right there. Just wow. Just both of you, great job singing.
Fantastic. Next up, we have Nick and Jacob doing a cover of Hip Hopopotamus versus Rhinoceros by Flight of the Conchords with some rapping and guitar. And then we have Olivia Power singing Gimme Gimme from Fairly Modern Millie. So it'll be great.
Mother flipping round rhinoceros, my beats are fat and the birds are on my back and I'm horny. If you choose to proceed, you will indeed concede, cause I hit you with my flow, the wild rhino stampede. I'm not just wild, I'm trained, investigated. I was raised by a rapper and rhino that dated and subsequently procreated. That's how it goes. He is the hip-hop-opotamus, the hip-hop hippo.
They call me the hip-hop-opotamus, my lyrics are bottomless.
Sometimes my rhymes are polite, like they keep dinner, Miss Wright. That was very delicious, good night. Sometimes they're obscene, like a pornographic dream. NC-17 with ladies in a stream of margarine. Yeah, margarine.
They call me the hip-hop-opotamus, flows like glowing phosphorus, popping off the top of this esophagus, rocking this metropolis. I'm not a large water-dwelling man. Where did you get that preposterous hypothesis? Did Steve tell you that, perchance? Steve.
Rhymes and records, they don't get played, because my records and rhymes, they don't get made. And if you rap like me, you don't get paid. And if you roll like me, you don't get laid.
My rhymes are so potent that in this small segment, I made all of the ladies in the area pregnant. Yes, sometimes my lyrics are sexist, but you lovely ladies should know that I'm trying to correct this.
Other rappers diss me, say my rhymes are sissy. Why?
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 Why exactly?
What? Why?
More constructive with your feedback, please.
Why?
Why?
Why? Why? Because I rap about reality. Like me and my grandma drinking a cup of tea. There ain't no party like banana tea party. Hey, ho. I'm the mother flippin'.
I'm the mother flippin'.
I'm the mother flippin'.
Who's the mother flippin'?
I'm the mother flippin'.
I'm the mother flippin'.
I'm the mother flippin'.
Mother flippin'.
A simple choice, nothing more. This or that, either or. Merrywell, social world, businessman. Clever girl, or pin my future on a green glass love. What kind of life am I dreaming of? I say, gimme, gimme. Gimme, gimme. Gimme, gimme that thing called love. I want it. Gimme, gimme that thing called love. I need it. Highs and lows, tears and laughter. Give me happy ever after. Give me that thing called love. Give me that thing called love. I crave it. Give me that thing called love. I'll brave it, thick and thin, rich or poor time. Give me years and I'll want more time. Give me that thing called love. Give me that thing called love.
Awesome, guys. Challenge from home, which we've been trying to do. Say hip-hop-opotamus 5 times fast. Also, Olivia, beautiful voice and acting as always.
Let's try it right now. Let's try the hip-hop-opotamus.
Hip-hop-opotamus.
That was great, guys.
I got it once.
Good job. Thank you. Thank you for that. We have some great acts coming up. Right now, we got Polly, and she'll be doing a drama presentation and called Too Much Soap Opera, Too Much Soap Opera, where she'll be reciting the lyrics of one of my favorite songs, Barbara Manatee, from the legend of a show, VeggieTales. If you haven't watched VeggieTales, watch it right now. It's good for all ages. And after Polly, we will have Jack Mosney, and he'll be performing She Used to Be Mine. And actually, guys, this is kind of serious. There's a case going on right now. And there's missing hair. We don't know where Jack's hair is. So if you have any, if you have any signs or like clues of Jack's hair, the whereabouts of it, please let us know. Anyways, let's move on to the act, shall we?
Isn't anything I can say or do now that'll make this any better.
What? Wow, man, that was crazy, Kate. Adrenaline's pumping. I'm going to bed.
Barbara Manatee, you are the one for me. Sent from up above, you are the one I love.
Please don't cry, Barbara. You're a nice manatee. You've been so good to me. But I must go into the world and do noble things for the good of all. And you can't come because you don't speak French. Oh, why?
But if you leave, Bill, who will take me to the ball? Who will take me to the ball, Bill? I have a new dress and shoes. And new mantine lipstick. Who will take me to the ball? Please don't go.
I must.
Don't go.
I must.
Don't.
Must.
Don't.
Must.
Barbara Manatee, you are the one for me. Sent from up above, you are the one I love.
Barbara Manatee, I'll be your mon ami. I'll take you to the ball. I hope you're not too tall.
Bill, I learned French.
You have?
Oui, je suis manatee. See?
Oui, oui, Barbara Manatee. I always knew you would. I always hoped you could. Now can we go into the world and do noble things for the good of all?
But first, Bill, will you take me to the ball? Oh, Bill.
I can't dance.
What?
No!
I must go.
Please don't go!
I must!
Don't go!
I must!
Don't!
Must!
Don't!
Must!
Barbara Manatee! You are the one for me! Sent from up above! You are the one I...
Ben, it was crazy. I've been watching way too many soap operas. Okay, I'm cut off.
It's not simple to say, but most days I don't recognize me. But these shoes and this apron, that place and its patrons, have taken more than I gave them. And it's not easy to know that I'm not anything like I used to be. Oh, it's true, I was never attention's sweet center, but I still remember that girl who's imperfect, but she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is broken and won't ask for help. She is messy, but she's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She is all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be mine. And it's not what I asked for. Sometimes life just slips in through a back door and carves out a person and makes you believe it's all true. And now I got you. You're not what I asked for. If I'm honest, I know I would give it all back for a chance to start over, then rewrite an ending or two for that girl that I knew, who was reckless just enough, who gets hurt but who learns how to toughen up when she's bruised and gets used by a man who can't love. And then she'll get stuck and be scared of the light that's inside her, growing stronger each day till it finally reminds her to fight just a little and bring back the fire in her eyes. She is gone, but she used to be mine. Oh, she used to be mine. She's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She is all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be mine.
Yeah, that was, wowza. That was awesome. I love that acting. I kind of got scared. I thought my mic was unmuted because I thought the dude character you're playing was me, and I got really freaked out. So great job. I love VeggieTales. And Jack, dude, your voice, love it, and your expressions. And Wait a minute. I just thought of the perfect song that can combine these two. Okay, ready, ready? Oh, where is Jack's hair? Oh, where is Jack's hair? Oh, where, oh, where, oh, where? Yeah, I have no idea where your hair is, Jack. I'm sorry. Wait, Jack, I actually have your hair right here. If you want to come pick it up, maybe like tomorrow or something. Okay, guys, don't worry. I asked Jack beforehand if I was allowed to bully him, and he said 100%. I love Jack. Jack is a great man, even without hair. So let's move on to our last two acts of Act 1.
And this is just a reminder that we're actually going to have a teacher Q&A coming up at intermission. We are actually, as Sydney said, very close to intermission. So if you have any questions for the teachers so far, we have Ms. Bethel, Drysdale, Gruber, Hunzi, and Ms. Lynch, who will be with us. And I think Ms. Rogerson. We'll see. Think of some questions you want to ask or just stuff you want to say, and we'll be reading the comments and asking the teachers.
Yeah, don't ask it yet, though. Ask it when.
Yeah, not yet. Yeah. Just think about it. So now we have Jessica singing Class of 21, which is an original song of hers, and Jillian Jung with her own animation, Saturday Morning.
I hope you guys are doing okay. I dedicate the song to all my friends. I miss you all. Here's the 2003s. Making stupid memories. So crazy. Still figuring out how to party. When we cry, we take a pic. Write a rant, then post about it. Hiding true feelings we won't admit. Cause we don't know how to deal with it. We're not depressed, we're a mess, we're the class of 21. We do stupid things and we have stupid dreams, but damn, we still have fun. We're not dying, but we're crying as we're lying on the bedroom floor. Our body's sore from nothing as we ignore the dangers of our dreams. Lying to our parents about our friends. Holding on too tightly to things that should end. We question every message you didn't send. Remaking stupid TikTok trends. We're not depressed, we're a mess, we're the class of 21. We do stupid things and we have stupid dreams, but damn, we still have fun. And we're not dying, but we're crying as we're lying on the bedroom floor. Our body's sore from nothing as we
always saying that we're unhappy. But the best time is when we're together, it seems. We're not depressed, we're a mess, we're the class of 21. Stupid things and we have stupid dreams, but damn, we still have fun. And we're not dying, but we're crying as we're lying on the bedroom floor. Our body's sore from everything as we ignore the dangers of our dreams.
Wow! Ah, that was so good. Jessica, like an original song, that was just really good. I loved it. You're so talented. And Jillian, I've told you many, many times, you're just fantastic. And I'm so proud of you and everything that you've done. And I was honored to have voiced and screamed for that animation. So we're at the intermission now.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's time for some... Oh, you know what we forgot? We forgot we're going to plug Jillian's account later if you're watching.
Oh, yeah,
this.
We are.
Yeah, because she has an Instagram account where she posts lots of arts stuff. So we'll,
And a YouTube.
So we'll post it down below. It's time for questions, and it's time to talk to our great teachers. They're waiting in the next room, the next chat room. So we got to go over. We got to go over to them. So, why don't you guys...
I guess we'll just hop over then now, yeah?
Yeah, let's just toggle over there. I'm going to see if I can... it's going to be just me for a second. Let's see if I can... I haven't tried this out yet, but we're going to try it out. We're going to see what happens when we go back here. And then... Hold up, folks. Let's go to the teacher chat.
talk to our teachers. They're waiting for chat. And then so we gotta go for it.
Alright. We're all here.
Yeah, let's just toggle over there.
And I can
see if I can
I can hear my own voice.
Yeah, yeah. One of our colleagues needs to mute for somebody to have the show going in the background.
It's every Zoom call ever. Okay. Who is the culprit? We must. It's good to see all you teachers. Sorry that it's a little hard to hear, but we'll technical difficulties, right?
We are chaos. We're always chaos.
Okay.
Sorry that it's a little hard to hear.
I don't like hearing my voice over and over again, but just write some questions in the chat.
Yeah. Any comments you want to make to a specific teacher? And we'll tell them. Everyone's just saying pure chaos right now.
This is chaotic. This is what Eastwood is.
Miss Lily says to mute everyone. Oh,
yeah.
How do we do that? It must have been Gruber. No, she's wearing headphones.
Or Rogerson.
Miss R has been muted.
We fixed it now.
It's fixed for now. I think Miss R, you were okay because you were muted for a while.
I don't think it was good. Yeah.
But hey, let's hear some questions. Tell us what you wanna tell them. Let's talk. Let's have a good talk. All right. They're saying we want to mute the teachers. Okay, I guess you guys can't talk. thanks for being patient with that, guys. We're losing teachers.
We have a question. Where's Mr. Clink?
Where's Mr. Clink? I think he's at his cottage right now. He's just relaxing, watching the stream.
Tell us what you wanna tell them.
I'm hearing my voice again. Oh no. It's a curse that could not be lifted. I don't know how to mute everybody, but that's okay. Let's see. How's Drysdale's rap career going? Let us know, Drysdale.
Thank you for asking. I was chomping at the bit to actually answer that question. I have been throwing so many lines down and beats down. I just don't know what to do with them all. But seriously speaking, can I just say something? I saw Miranda was there. I saw Gordon was there. And I know I talked to Ben Skipper a while back, but for all the music council chairs that have run The Floor Is Yours, I just think it's amazing to see this new evolution of what was once this live venue, and to see it somehow bringing everyone together giving us that sense of community that we're all thriving for, we're all striving, trying to get. And I don't know, for this is just me thinking, student leadership has really impressed me over the years, but when I see what you four have done, putting tonight together and trying to corral all the teachers this afternoon to try to get the technical difficulties sorted and all of that, and all of the work that you guys put in to make this happen, so we all can share tonight together. I'm just saying thank you for that, and for all previous music council chairs for running previous mute Floor Is Yours, because I don't think tonight would be happening at all if it weren't for Floor Is Yours. And for all the previous student leadership that went into those events, because you kind of have an idea of how it might look, and that's why last time worked, right? So anyway, this is just a shout out to all of the music councils of the past and arts councils of the past that made this happen. And you guys in particular tonight, that's what I wanted to say. I'm done. Unless there's a question.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I have a question from Parker. I just had the question. It's who is your favorite student band? Or maybe like, what is your favorite band? Anybody want to take that one? Or we could pick another question. That's...
Well, who's... If no one else will say anything, my favorite band is Arcade Fire, but most people know that.
That's a good idea. Let's pass it around. We'll do it one at a time. Thank you for all muting yourselves. Gruber, what's your favorite band? Student band. I think.
Oh, man, I was going to say the teacher band. Just because that's a nasty, tricky question. I'm sticking with teacher band because I didn't know I couldn't say that before I said it. So I claim it.
There you go. Hunzi, what's your favorite student band or, I guess, band? Uh-oh, Hunzi's frozen. Let it go, Hunzi. Let it go. We'll talk to you later, Hunzi. It's okay. Miss Bethel is loading forever, but we'll get back to her soon. Miss Lynch, what's your favorite band or student band?
I'm going to have to go with the Beatles for my favorite band.
That's good. If only there was a student's Beatles band. Mm-hmm. That would be cool, too.
Maybe that should be great.
Might be
counting
as the Beatles cover band.
Yeah. Miss R, it's your turn. What's your favorite student band or band, I guess?
The Beatles.
The Beatles. Good choice.
Or Marty and the Nightcaps.
Yes, that band I most definitely know and have heard of before.
My son was in it. What can I say?
Oh, wow. Let's find some more questions. Keep them coming, guys. We should have added a hashtag or something.
I have one.
Okay.
It's from Morgan, and it's Gruber. What do you miss the most about school?
Oh, I definitely miss being in 224 when I'd have a chance to sit in front of a computer once in a while. Right? So much square eyes and so much time spent in front of a computer. But, well, at least it's a way to be together, which is good. And obviously, really, I miss you. I miss this is amazing to see you guys and see your art and see you in the chat. And that's what I missed. And I love, at least whether it's this way or the old way or whatever the new way is, you know, seeing the alumni and seeing the staff and seeing everybody come together and just celebrate each other. That's what's awesome. So if it has to be in front of a screen, then so be it. But obviously I miss you. So this is a great way to get to see you.
Do we want to pass that question on to everyone else as well? Like starting with Drysdale.
Let's do that, yeah.
What do you miss most about school, Mr. Drysdale? We'll go from bottom to top again.
Okay. I'll be quick. This job stinks without you guys, without the students. Like it really, and the colleagues, I love working with my colleagues and we do get a chance to see them every week and at meetings and everything. So not to say that, but really without working with students, it's hard to say that I'd want to continue doing this if it looked like this for more than a year or two. I'd maybe go back to framing houses. So it's definitely you guys.
All right. Can Hunzi speak? No? Maybe? What's your favorite? Your favorite, or what do you miss most about school, Hunzi?
Oh, she's deafened.
Okay. You can't, you're muted. Okay.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. She can't hear what we're saying. That's too bad. Moving on for now. Ms. Lynch, what do you miss most about school? Tell us.
So, I miss all of you guys. But I also really miss set painting on Saturdays when Gruber would bring in her dogs and we'd have Timbits, and it was just so much fun. I really miss that.
And Miss R, it's your turn. I know you are happily retired now, but what do you miss about Eastwood in school?
I would say the lower hallway where there are dancers and there's actors and there's singers and instrumentalists, and it's just a really cool energy. And yeah, I really miss that part.
Lovely. Let's see if we can get a couple more questions. Someone asks.
We have another one. Or you got one.
No, okay. No, you go ahead.
Oh, I was just, my mom texted me and she said, what is one thing you left at school before it closed and you wish you brought home?
Do you want to start Drysdale again? Start at the top?
Yeah.
I'll just say that I cheated because we had a window to go back and I got all the stuff. And I've got like, I think I got way too many things actually. So I'll let someone else answer.
Gruber, your turn.
I want to go in and get Jake his puppets back for Smash It so he can have them. And then just all the other things I remember, but I don't remember I need them until I need them. And then they're sitting on the desk or in the drawer.
I get that. How about you, Miss Lynch? What did you forget if you could go back?
I left my mom's Singer sewing machine in my classroom. I'm probably going to get in trouble if I don't get that back at some point.
Me too. I also have the sewing machine in 224 waiting for its big debut on the stage, but it too is stranded there.
Mm-hmm. Well, I started packing in December and I didn't leave a thing.
It's all gone, right? Not a speck dust, I guess. let's find another question. I'm sorry about Hunzi and Bethel. If we'll have to talk to them another time because we're having technical difficulties. But where is another question? Help me out, guys. Gotta find maybe a couple more.
We have one.
I saw one. It was asking what new skills or hobbies have been picked up over quarantine.
That's a good one. Let's start from the bottom to the top this time. Is that okay? Just to change things up. Miss R, what have you learned? if you want to tell us. You're muted, Miss R.
Muted.
Yeah, I've learned some great impressions. Some really, really good impressions. The very best. They're excellent. I mean, you ask anybody, we're better than anyone. I've got the best.
Thank you, Miss R.
That was wonderful.
I was laughing. I had to mute myself, though, but that was great.
That was pretty sad. Sorry about that.
No, it was pretty darn good. Miss Lynch, what have you learned? Or any new hobbies?
I have taken up gardening. I now water my lawn every day in my garden. I never did before. And I've also done a little bit of painting, which I've never really been into. So I'm liking it.
All right, Gruber, it's your turn.
I finally had the chance through necessity to get into Premiere Pro and try to make Sidney Heemster proud of me with some editing skills. And I had to learn a little bit about Discord and streaming and how to do every possible thing that you can't do in person digitally.
And Drysdale?
Hunzi she's on the chat and she said we don't have time to pick up new things, and Gruber would have picked that up out of necessity too, I think. We're just scrambling to stay on top of things right now. It's been busier than ever. Minus musical. Musical time's busier. Let's keep that in mind. But we did remove 1.5 tons worth of stuff from our backyard. We got a bin, and that's what my wife and I worked on. We just got rid of a whole pile of stuff.
Solid. That's pretty great. I think Miss Bethel is invisible. We cannot see her or hear her, but Should we do one more question? Maybe
we have some more teachers who are trying to get in here.
Okay.
I'm trying to let Helmer join, but
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, Helmer, if you're still watching, we've sent you an email and a DM, thing.
She's in here. Just trying to get her onto the voice channel.
In the meantime,
bro, I didn't see.
Let's find another question.
It said yeah.
Lots of people. I think Jake wants his puppets back. He's pretty upset about that.
Yes.
So we should get him his puppets back very soon.
I think Miss Ligati had a question, a mom question from way back. I don't know what it was, a parent question.
Oh.
I think it was about what types of foods you've been making.
Oh.
Oh.
That's a good one. Let's
quarantine you.
I guess we can start with Drysdale again. What kind of foods have you been making?
I don't know if anyone gets the box, but with my wife being a midwife, being on call, and I have a couple of go-tos that I cook, and she's getting tired of my go-tos, and I get it. So we get that box deal, where they send you a box of food that you have to prep. And so it's something different every week, and we love it. I don't know if you know what I'm talking about. Does anyone know what I'm talking about? Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
There you go. That's what we're eating a lot of.
Nice. Gruber, what have you been eating a lot of or anything new?
I did actually, despite resisting it for a while, get sucked into the homemade bread culture. And so now I know what more about yeast and chemistry and leaven and stuff than I thought. But despite, my concerns, I actually made homemade bread a few times, which was impressive. Just on a side note, on a sneak peek, since I did have a chat with Jake, if you're interested in seeing a little bit about the puppets, then be sure to tune into Arts Banquet in a month.
Look who's arrived. Welcome, Miss Elmer. I need to find out a way to mute. I think Miss Bethel is. Oh no, Miss Bethel is causing some.
Somebody's.
It's not letting me right click for some reason, but that's
everyone's
okay.
Everyone's asking for a baby update. Oh, the chat's exploding.
Let me try to, Miss Bethel, could you mute the chat if you can? Oh, I think she just saw Miss Helmer for the first time.
Oh, she.
Oh, wait.
She looks very excited.
I'm going to have to. Okay, she's muted. She's gone for now, but we'll unmute her later if she comes back. Miss Helmer, do you want to tell us anything? Tell us all your crazy stories.
All your crazy stories.
Hi, crew. Can you hear me? Yeah, you can hear me? Sweet.
Mom, are you stuck
in the hospital?
Are you in labor right now?
No, I'm not. I am waiting to be induced. It hasn't worked. They've tried twice. So I'm just waiting. Who knows? So you guys got to start taking bets on when the baby's coming.
Okay. Anything else you'd like to say?
I miss you guys so much. This is the worst time ever. E-learning, no band, no music, no kids, stuck in a hospital bed so I can't even talk to anybody. Worst time ever, but you guys are making my day just seeing you on Google Classroom, and this screen is yours is hilarious. And it's making being in a hospital bed, having a baby, way more tolerable, I guess. Just I miss my band kids. I miss you guys. That's all.
Soon there will be one kid.
Right? I'll have one.
I wanted to ask if you had any baby names.
We do. Yeah. It's going to be a surprise, though. So,
okay.
And all my teacher friends know how hard naming your baby is when you're a teacher.
That makes sense. Yes.
Yeah. And no, it's not a German name. So again, start taking bets on names.
Okay. Before.
Yeah, now people are asking if you named it my name.
And no, Cody, I'm not naming it Cody. Trombone. Yeah, I'm naming her trombone.
Name her Bubba. Bubba the pink trombone.
Bubba Halbert.
I mean, wouldn't be weirder than Elon Musk's.
X9.
I don't know how to say it, man.
Do we want to do one more question and get the show on the road?
I think that's a good idea.
Yeah. So do we want to wrap up the food question and then one more?
Yeah. I tried something brand new and I love it. It's chaffle.
Tell us more.
Look it up.
Okay, I will. I will look it up later.
Avocado on top.
Ooh,
awesome. That does sound pretty darn good. Miss Lynch, tell us your food.
Well, my husband doesn't let me cook. He's a bully in the kitchen, so he cooks everything. But I started baking. I've been baking muffins. I made chocolate chip muffins and banana muffins, and it turned out pretty good, actually.
That's good. Miss Helmer, before you were in a hospital bed, did you get a chance to cook anything?
My husband is also a kitchen tyrant, and so he cooks things. Dre, what'd you cook recently? Go.
I don't remember. We've been here for the last 5 days.
Yeah. What's the best thing you've cooked?
That was a steak I made in the cast iron pan. That was
delicious. Yeah, a Gordon Ramsay steak. The best.
There you go.
Solid. That's pretty great. I think we can have one more question. And we're sorry. I know Miss Lily tried to get in and Miss Bethel and Hunzi was in for a sec. We're sorry we couldn't keep them on. Technical difficulties. Does anybody have one more question for everyone? One more question. Anybody? Anybody? I'm scrolling back. A lot of baby talk. Baby, baby, baby. Ryan placed, Mr. Hume placed his bet May 22nd at 6:34 p.m. That's not a question, though. Where?
That's a bet, yeah.
Someone says, I have a question, but they didn't say what the question was. Any more questions?
Legati is asking, how much do you miss us? Oh.
Sorry, I've got one from Jake Evans Whitley that says, do you have any word on when Callum's album is coming out to Drysdale?
Good, very good question. he's still working on things. He's on a chord progression right now that he's obsessed with, and that's always a good thing. But I don't have an update for you on that. I'm really sorry about that. But he is going to Laurier next year, so that's a big plus.
All right.
I am also going to Laurier.
Maybe one more question for everyone, and then we'll get the show on the road. Jessica Legati says, how much do you miss us? I think we already answered that one.
You
miss us a lot. I know.
It's wonderful.
Any more? Do you like Taylor's film? They all love it. They love it a lot. Probably. Most likely. Where?
You know, Sydney, they might just want to hear more music.
I think that's a great idea.
I think that's a good idea.
Yeah, let's move on.
Thank you so much, teachers, for coming out. Thank you for asking questions. Sorry we couldn't get it to all of them. You can email them as well. They'd be happy to talk. Thank you for coming back, Miss R.
Don't forget about us. We're still in school.
Yes.
Just like this. We'll see you all in Google Classroom, where you're supposed to be.
Yes. Okay. I'm going to...
End of June. Not the beginning of June.
Yeah, that's right. We're not working this hard for you to disappear. We miss you, but we still want to see you in Google Class.
All right. Farewell, teachers, for now. Yeah. It was great to see you. I'm going to transfer over to the other screen, but you'll still be able to hear me.
Make sure you're...
Uh-oh. Gotta make it full screen. You're gonna see all my private information. That's not good.
They could have seen my profile picture.
Oh,
oh
no.
Now they see our chat.
Oh. Our chats.
Interesting.
No, we're good. Everything's fine. Everything's golden. We got our fancy border back. They can't see my face. Okay, so... So, we would like to once again apologize for cutting out those videos and cutting off Dylan's and cutting off, I'm sorry, Maia and Dylan. So, we're going to play it really quick, except I need to add it into the collection of videos and stuff. So, it's going to be a couple seconds. You guys do want to just keep on talking and keep things going while I set things up, okay? We're going to play your video again. It's going to be great. Thank you, guys.
Next up, we have the Sitters and the Makers, and they'll be doing their original song, Achoo!
Bless you.
Thank you. I was waiting for you to say something. No, that wasn't a sneeze. That's the name of their original song. Yeah, it will be a music video. And make sure that you also check them out on Bandcamp. We have a link in the description below. And after the Sitters and the Makers, we have Victoria doing a little dance, and it's going to be great. So hit it, Sydney.
Hey, I'm not ready yet. I'm trying to get Dylan's video ready.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'm not that quick. I need to hang in there. Okay.
Don't hit, Sydney.
Hey, I think this is a video and it should be playing right now, so let me mute myself.
Hi, how are you? Every morning he got up, dreading each moment he had to be awake. He'd look at the floor and scribble on gum wrappers. He never found a better way to joke around. The clock would tick and time went slow, and there wasn't anywhere he wouldn't go to avoid having to see anyone. He'd sit in a chair, he'd lean against the wall. It just didn't seem to matter much at all. But late at night, he had a savior in his sleep, in his dreams. She came to him and she said, poor you, poor you. No one understands you, poor you, poor you. And every word that everyone would say got mumbled up in his head. Like mumble jumble, and everywhere he went, it seemed everyone was saying to him, blah, blah, blah. But late at night, he had a mistress in his dream, in his sleep. And she would say, poor you, poor you, no one understands you.
Thank you.
Okay, we're back. That was great. Thank you, Dylan, for letting us do that. And thank you, everyone else. That was great. Super abstracty. Loved it. You know how to make a crazy film. Thank you, Dylan. And he has it on his YouTube channel, too, if you want to watch it again. We're going to jump right in to Maia because we completely skipped hers. And we got to see those mushrooms that she drew. She does a very fun time lapse of mushroom drawing. So let's bring up that video. It's going to be a little sloppy like last time. So bear with me for a second. I just got to find the video. Thank you, guys. And then right after this, we're going to jump right into the videos that Caitlin...
I introduced. Yep.
We're going to...
I know he said keep talking, and I thought he meant keep talking.
Okay, I think the video is going to play right away. So here is Maia, and she's going to draw some mushrooms. It's going to be good. And we're back right away. It just cuts like that. Lovely mushrooms. I loved them. And the music was vibing. Thank you for letting us play it later. I'm sorry about the technical difficulties. But we got to move on because we have 20 more acts to go. I'm just going to re-announce it just in case you forgot. We're going to listen to the Sitters and the Makers. Sorry. Bless me. That was the name of their song, Achoo. And there is mild use of alcohol in this video. Of someone who is of age, so they're okay to drink it. No underage drinking. And then we have Victoria, who's doing some dancing to Sia, and it's gonna be really great. So I really hope you guys enjoy. Let's just jump right into it. Let's see if I remember how to do this. It's been a while.
soon to own on Bandcamp and Spotify.
Oh shoot, the video's playing over top. Oh no, that wasn't supposed to happen. We loved that video so much we had to play it a second time for 1 second. I'm just gonna remove it. Wow, that was great. I love The Sitters and Makers, such an awesome song.
That was good.
So catchy, so good. Yeah. And don't forget, check out their EP, link in the description. It's a care package, and you can listen to it. It'll make you feel better. And Victoria, that dancing, dang, that was some really great dancing. I wish my body could move that way, but I haven't been practicing a lot, so props to you. That was awesome. And we forgot to say, the link in the description below, we should have a link to a form where you can give us feedback on the show. I know there's lots of technical difficulties. We can fix that next time. But also, take some photos of you watching the event and like take a picture of your family, some selfies with the video on the TV or something. Take some pictures. You can submit them directly to the form. Link in the description below. Let's keep this show going on the road. We got 18 more acts to go. Let's go. Rock and roll.
Epic. So next up, we've got Cole Allen singing a cover of Be My Mistake. Finna be epic. You can also check out his EP, which is not of this, but of his own song, which he wrote, which is great. And you should do that in the bio. You can also, and then next we're going to watch Naomi singing Boy from the Country and playing the guitar. And that's going to be equally as awesome. And I'm just looking forward to both of these. Let's go.
I got to mute myself. I'm sorry. I forgot to hit the mute button.
Hey, my name is Cole Allen. I won't be singing an original today because can't get inspired, locked inside all day. Am I right, folks? Am I right? But I'm crash. I'm actually doing comedy act. That's a lie. So I'm going to sing a cover called Be My Mistake by the 1975. Mistake. So don't wait outside my hotel room. Just wait till I give you a sign. Cause I get lonesome sometimes. Save all the jokes you're gonna make while I see how much drink I can take and be my mistake.
Awesome.
Yeah, that was super good. Kate, you both have just angel-like voices, and that's all I have to say, to be honest. That's all.
Yeah. Next up, we've got some more angels, I guess. We've got singing Hey Jupiter, and then we've got Lauren dancing to Mystery of Love by Sophia Stevens, and the performance is called Innocence.
And it was recorded before the pandemic happened when school, I guess it'll say in the video. Let's get things going.
Thank you. No one's picking up the phone. Guess it's me and me and this little masochist. She's ready to confess all the things that I never thought she could feel. Hey Jupiter, nothing's been the same. So are you gay? Are you blue? Thought we both could use a friend to run to. And I thought I wouldn't have to be with you. Something new. Sometimes I breathe you in, and I know you know. And sometimes you take a swim, found your writing on my wall. If my heart's soaking wet, boy, boots can leave a mess. Hey Jupiter, nothing's been the same. So are you gay? Are you blue? Thought we both could use a friend to run to. And I thought you wouldn't have to keep with me. Between the shower or the bath, and I thought I wouldn't have to be with you. A magazine. Guess I thought I could never feel the things I feel. Hey Jupiter, nothing's been the same. So are you gay? Are you blue? Thought we both could use a friend to run to. Hey Jupiter, nothing's been the same. So are you safe? Now we're through. Thought we both could use a friend to run to. Hey Jupiter.
Thank you.
baby.
Sorry, I had to clap a little more.
That was amazing. Jillian, your voice is beautiful. And then Lauren, that was a really great dance. It's always really cool to see what you come up with.
Mm-hmm. All right. So
now we have Matt, and he's doing a cover song of Call You Mine, and he has like a little music video. And then we also have Carmen, who was my stand partner in Pitt, and I miss you, Carmen. And I'm sorry if I annoyed you. and she's going to be singing Hug All Your Friends by Cave Town.
Two kids with their hearts on fire, who's going to save us now? When we thought that we couldn't get higher, things started looking down. I look at you and you look at me like nothing but strangers now. Two kids with our hearts on fire, don't let it burn us out. Think about what you believe in now. Am I someone you cannot live without? Cause I know I don't wanna live without you. Yeah, come on, let's turn this all around. Bring it on back to the bottom town, when you wouldn't let me walk out on you. Yeah, you said, hey, what you doing for the rest of your life? And I said, I don't even know what I'm doing tonight. Went from one conversation to your lips and mine. And you said I never regretted the day that I called you mine. So I called you mine. City, drunk on the subway train. Set free every time you kissed me, but couldn't feel no pain. You looked at me and I looked at you like we'd never look away. Broke kids running through the city, don't let the memory fade. You said, hey, what you doing for the rest of your life? I said, I don't even know what I'm doing tonight. Went from one conversation to your lips on mine. And you said I never regretted the day that I called you mine. So I called you mine. And you said I never regretted the day that I called you mine. Think about what you believe in now. Am I someone you cannot live without? Cause I know I don't want to live without you. Yeah, come on, let's turn this all around. Bring it on back to the bottom town, when you wouldn't let me walk out on you. Yeah, you said, hey, what you doing for the rest of your life? I said, I don't even know what I'm doing tonight. Went from one conversation to your lips on mine. And you said I never regretted the day that I called you mine. Can I call you mine?
Hug All Your Friends by Cape Town.
What's it like to be alone?
yesterday, sing me a song, tell me your thoughts. I could listen to you all night long, and I don't care about my sleeping routine. I messed it up as it is, but we've got so much time to kill before the night runs me to sleep. Life's too short to worry about things that we got wrong. So hug all your friends and let them know you're not letting go. I'm not letting go. Do you remember when we felt like animations? Didn't need A grades for self-validation.
Wow, we sure got some renaissance folks. Yeah, like Matt and Carmen, I don't think I've heard you sing, or not a lot for that matter. So that was so good. A lot of hard work putting that clearly. So proud of you guys.
Wonderful job. And Carmen is only in grade 9. Crazy. Crazy.
Yeah,
talk. Anyways, let's keep on moving. Our next acts, we got Lena. She'll be reading a classic storybook, Scaredy Squirrel Makes a Friend. So make sure to grab your cat. Grab your blankets and your teddy bears. It's a really good story. And after that one, we have Nora. And they got some late night mischief going on. It's a video where they're skateboarding and it's pretty funky. So let's get things rolling again.
Hello, everybody. Welcome. I did end up finding another Scaredy Squirrel book, going back to the classic. So today I'm going to be reading Scaredy Squirrel Makes a Friend by Melanie Watt. Warning! Scaredy Squirrel insists that everyone brush their teeth with germ-fighting toothpaste before reading this book. Scaredy Squirrel Makes a Friend by Melanie Watt. Scaredy Squirrel doesn't have a friend. He'd rather be alone than risk encountering someone dangerous. A squirrel could get bitten. A few individuals Scaredy Squirrel is afraid to be bitten by. Walruses, bunnies, beavers, piranhas, and Godzilla. So Scaredy Squirrel finds interesting ways to pass the time all by himself. He reads, he whistles, he crafts, he yawns, he knits, he chats, he counts. Until one day, he spots someone perfectly safe, a goldfish. The perfect friend, according to Scaredy Squirrel,
bubbly personality, quiet, squeaky clean, no teeth, and germ-free. Doesn't do much, but is 100% safe. A few items Scaredy Squirrel needs to make the perfect friend. Lemon, name tag, mittens, comb, mirror air freshener toothpaste, and chew toy. How to make the perfect first impression. Prepare freshly squeezed lemonade. Make sure name tag is visible. Tame bad hair. Brush teeth thoroughly and practice smile. Check for nutty breath and food caught between teeth. Make sure name tag is visible. Wear mittens to hide sweaty paws. Use pine scent to smell delightful. Follow the perfect plan. The perfect plan. Step 1. Toss down chew toy to distract biters. Step 2. Use mirror to check hair and teeth. Step 3. Run to fountain. Step 4. Point to name tag and smile. Step 5. Offer lemonade. Step 6. Make the perfect friend. Don't talk to suspicious bunnies. Stay away from piranha-infested ponds. Beware of walruses. They're fast on their flippers. Avoid beavers. They could snap at any moment. Goldfish is here, and I am here. Watch out for Godzilla, for obvious reasons. But let's say, just for example, that Scaredy Squirrel did come face to face with a potential biter. He knows exactly what not to do. Do not show fear. Do not show your fingers. Do not make eye contact. Do not make any loud noises. If all else fails, play dead. And hand over the test. Scaredy's risk test. Number 1. Who are you? Walrus, piranha, bunny, Godzilla, beaver, or other? Number 2. How many teeth do you have? 2, 100, 10, 1,000, 32, or other? Number 3. What's your hobby? Biting or other? Number 4. What do you see? Friend or something to bite? With every detail under control, Scaredy Squirrel puts the plan into action. First, he tosses the chew toy. Then, he heads down the tree. Everything is perfect until he hears a strange sound coming from behind. Squeak! And he realizes... it's a dog! This was not part of the plan. The dog chases Scaredy Squirrel around the bush, around the fountain, and around in circles, until Scaredy Squirrel plays dead. 30 minutes later, 1 hour later, 2 hours later? After all this time, Scaredy Squirrel realizes that the dog does not want to bite him. He just wants a friend. Scaredy Squirrel points to his name tag and smiles. Then he starts chasing his new buddy. They play fetch, they play hide and seek, and they play dead. Scaredy Squirrel forgets all about the goldfish, not to mention the walruses, bunnies, beavers, piranha, and Godzilla. Time flies when you're having fun. All this excitement inspires Scaredy Squirrel to make a few minor changes to his idea of a friend. My almost perfect friend, according to Scaredy Squirrel. Muddy paws, wet doggy smell, loud bark, drool, tooth, and germs. 83% safe, but lots of fun. P.S. As for the wet doggy smell, well, it's been taken care of.
Good. It's crazy who makes me the happiest can make me the saddest. Look, Alice, let's get lost in your wonder. I'm Alice, you're perfectly perfect for me. What the is this practice? Actually, if you even consider leaving, I lose a couple screws in due time, I'll stop breathing. And you'll see the meaning of stalking when I pop out the dark to find you. And that new dude that you're seeing with an attitude that proceeds to end up your evening. Make sure you never meet again like God vegan. Cause when I hear your name, I can.
Awesome job, guys. Lena, such a great narrator voice. Everyone's saying I love it. You should consider vocal. What's it called? Voice acting. Do it. Read some books. Also, Nora, that was definitely some chaotic late night mischief right there. And it was a fun time. So thank you for sharing your skateboarding and all that good stuff. Let's keep things moving.
All right, next up, we've got Jake Evans Whitley doing a sick monologue called Fears of Zero by Jerry Joel. And then we're going to have Jasmine singing A Thousand Years, which is going to be super epic as well.
Late at night. The world sleeps. And I'm here alone. And here I come some nights to confront my fears. Yes, they're here, my fears. They're always with me. They come. And they go. But though they are gone, they are never far. But here, alone, at night, I can confront them. There they are, confronted fears. Yes, fears of hunger, fears of pain. Ow! Fear of missing the last train. Fear of dentists always drilling. Fear that no one will be willing to see me as I know I really am. But once they're counted and compelled, they can quickly be dispelled. Like figments of my own imagination. But then, there are other fears. Fears of snakes. Fears of cats. Fears of maitre d's and rats. And rational black terror that someday I may grow fat. Fear of elevators falling and the taxman someday calling and the accidental walling of myself up inside a dingy dead old cellar where the spiders weave around me and the worms and squirmy things and bugs squiggle and squirm at my person. I love it! But once they're counted and compelled, they can quickly be dispelled. But then, there are still other fears. Fears of bullets. That's a dread. Fear of balding on the head. Fear of waking up one morning to discover you are dead. Once they're counted and compelled, they can quickly be dispelled. Like figments of my own imagination. But then there is the last fear. Just about the time when I'm past fear. the one that really is final. It will come, yours and mine. With no warning, in the night, it will come without a fight. It will count me. It will compel me. And it will casually dispel me. But I am just a figment of its own imagination.
Hello, my name is Jasmine, and I'm going to be singing A Thousand Years by Christina Perry. It's one of my all-time favorite songs, and I'm so excited to sing it, and I hope you enjoy it. Heart beats fast, colors and promises. How to be brave? How can I love when I'm afraid to fall? But watching you stand alone, all of my doubt suddenly goes away somehow. One step closer, I have died every day waiting for you. Darling, don't be afraid, I have loved you for a thousand years. I love you for a thousand more. Time stands still, beauty in all she is. I will be brave, I will not let anything take away what's standing in front of me. Every breath, every hour has come to this. One step closer, I have died every day waiting for you. Darling, don't be afraid, I have loved you for a thousand years. I love you for a thousand more. And all along I believed I would find you. Time has brought your heart to me.
Oh, we're so happy. Okay. That was Jake Evans Whitley performing a cool, fun monologue, and followed by Jasmine Kaur singing a cool, fun song.
It was really good. We have the beautiful, wonderful, talented Caitlin Cook singing a cover of Fuel for Fire by M. Ward, which also has a little bit of violin. And then me, playing piano and goofing off, I guess.
Right, let's hear it. Yeah. Woo. Thank you.
Piano, also I'm wearing Eastwood stuff. This piece this year holds a special meaning to me, and apparently it's also quite calming, so I decided to ask people what else made them feel calm, and then add some things that make me feel calm, and mix it all up into a video that might help people wind down. I know disclaimers are generally against the coffeehouse rules, but I would like to make one, and that is that there's a little bit of clipping in the audio. Kind of goes hand in hand with the quality of the shots. We're at home, we make do with what we have, so I would just be careful with your volume. On that note, here's a piece. It's still a work in progress, and it's Poulenc's Novelette in C major. And I hope it makes you feel relaxed.
Thank you. happens here? What happens here, good or bad? Absolutely happens in the time that you see it happen. There.
I loved it so much.
Megan, you're just lovely and a lovely pianist. And it just makes me so happy. And thank you guys for all the kind comments in the chat.
They're so nice. Thank you.
Yeah, made my day. Oh.
Music University time.
So next up we have Sam Tice singing with her older sister. And they'll be singing a little duet. And it's called You Love Who You Love from Bonnie and Clyde. And then after that, we have our very own Parker singing Stronger Man, and it's a little music video. And it also says here that's an original song. And it also says that there's a new EP coming out at the end of the month. So make sure you check out the link in the description to listen to more of Parker's music.
Yeah.
Hey guys, so tonight I'm going to be singing yet another musical theater song for you. It's actually a duet, and it's called You Love Who You Love from Bonnie and Clyde. And tonight my sister's joining me, and we're singing it together. So it took us like an hour to finish a 3-minute song, so I hope you enjoy.
Down the road while the fairy tale seems real.
not strong enough to hold you up. Will you not hang on me? If I was a stronger man, you'd be stronger for me. Do you love me when the weather is fair? If I was a better man, if I was not shy, you'd be sweet. But I am not a better man, and you are not sweet to me. I think about you often.
You know what this reminds me of? When Parker Merlihan sang that one song that goes like, strong men tremble when they hear it, you know?
They're right. Much you know, blacker I think than it's too they soon for all that's too soon, man.
Okay, never mind.
Anyways. Sam, that was some lovely singing, and say thanks to your older sister as well. That was great. I wish my siblings would do stuff with me, but so that's really sad. And Parker, that was just wonderful. Like, good quality, everything. Singing in the music video, I'm really proud of how far you've come. So,
alrighty, folks, I know it's getting late, but we have 4 more acts to go, 2 videos to go. And guess what? We got a surprise at the very end, at the credits, and it has something to do with the teachers, and they could potentially be monkeying around, so you definitely don't want to miss that or these next 4 acts. And don't forget, submit your feedback in the description below, check out all the links there, send your photos, take some photos. We're almost done this night. Next up, we have Jada, and she will be singing Leader of the Landslide by the Lumineers. It's a cover. She'll be singing, playing guitar. And after that, we have Alice. And it's going to be a good one because it's a classic, Take Me Home, Country Roads. Can't go wrong with that. So please enjoy these next acts coming up.
Hello, my name is Jada, and this is my attempt at a cover of the song Leader of the Landslide by the Lumineers. Every night I saw you there in your old wicker chair sing. You were wrong, I was right. Didn't matter in a fight, sing. Coffee mug filled it up. Always knew what it was, sing. Been on your side for years, You could never love without crying. Is she dead? Is she fine? Every day, every night. Fate has dealt me a lonely blow, I said. Tried to help, only hurt. In the end, I made it worse. Sing. Is she dead? Is she fine? Every day, every night. I'm sure some of you know me. My name's Alice, or Allison, or Allie, but mostly Alice. And I am not super confident in my singing or guitar ability, so this is kind of a jump for me. I'm kind of scared. But I'm going to be singing a classic that I enjoy. It's a bit of a memeable song, but honestly, I think it's honestly a good song. I'm saying it. I'll listen to it and be like, damn, this is a great song. But I'm going to sing Country Roads, Take Me Home by John Denver. Here it is. Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, blowing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place I belong.
West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home, country roads, all my memories gather round her. Mine is lady, stranger to blue water, dark and dusty, painted in the sky, misty taste of moonshine, teardrop in my eye. Country roads, take me home to the place I belong, West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home, country roads. I hear her voice in the morning hour, she calls me. The radio reminds me of my home far away. And driving down the road, I got a feeling that I should have been here yesterday. Yesterday, country roads, take me home to the place I belong, West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home, country roads.
Oh boy, I'm real nervous. I'm real nervous about this.
Yeah, my light's not on, but wow. That was wonderful, guys. I love your voices. And Jada, you're only in grade 9. Insane. Alice, I forget what grade you're in, but dang, you can keep singing because you got a good voice and you know how to play guitar. So thank you, guys. That was awesome. I was bopping along the whole time. Let's go on to our last two acts and then the secret surprise at the end.
We're on the home stretch, but stick around after these two. First, we have Megan singing Six from Six the Musical. It's also a music video. And then we have the Dinermans, who we all know and love. And they're performing I Don't Want to See You Crying Anymore by Adam. I think it's Melcher. I should know this. yeah, you should check out the Dinermans. They brought on, I think, YouTube.
We'll link to the YouTube later. We only have their EP, but we'll link that soon.
Check Spotify.
Check it out.
All right, let's go.
Nunnery. Joined the gospel choir, our riffs were on fire. At the top of the charts is where I'm gonna stay. Henry sent me a poem all about my green sleeves. I changed a couple words, put it on a sick beat. The song blew their minds, next minute I was signed. And now I'm writing lyrics for Shake's EP. Since my first son, our family's grown. We've made a band and got quite well known. Perhaps call us the Tudor Von Trapps. I'm just kidding, we're called the Roiling Stones.
We're one of a kind, no category. Too many years lost in history. We're free to take our crown in glory for 5 more minutes. We're six.
What a shame, yeah, my face, it cost me the crown. So I moved to the
House of Holbein
in my hometown. His mates were super arty, but I showed them how to party. Now on my tour of Prussia, everybody gets down.
Music man tried it on and I was like, bye. So I thought, who needs him? I can give it a try. I learned everything, now all I do is sing. And I'll do that until I die.
Heard all about these rocky chicks, loved every song and each remix. So I went out and
of a kind, no category. Too many years lost in history. We're free to take our crowning glory for 5 more minutes. We're six. Whoa, whoa, we're six. Whoa, oh, oh, we're six. Whoa, whoa, for 5 more minutes. It's the end of the show of the history mix. We switched up the flow and we changed the prefix. Everybody knows that we used to be six wise. But we wanna say before we drop the curtain, nothing is for sure, nothing is for certain. All that we know.
It's James and Kelb from the Diner Mints.
This is the first of a series of videos we're calling Takeout Sessions. Since we can't perform live right now, we thought we'd record ourselves performing from our homes and share it on our YouTube channel to keep spreading that Diner Mints love.
Our first Takeout Session is a cover of I Don't Want to See You Crying Anymore by Adam Melcher. We hope you enjoy.
Trust me like before. My head's in my hands as I'm shaking on the bathroom floor. I don't wanna see you crying anymore. I don't wanna see you crying anymore. I just wanna be the reason you can smile till you're sore. Unless it's something beautiful or joy you can't control. I don't wanna see you crying anymore. Are my mistakes worth the toll that it takes? I can see it written on your face. You've seen me make create to keep you out until it's just too late. I've made a mess like I've never cleaned before. I don't wanna see you crying anymore. Crying anymore. I don't need to play the game with you, 'cause there's no keeping score. But if you don't think you'll win with me, I'll chalk it up as a loss. 'Cause I don't wanna see you crying anymore. Are my mistakes worth the toll that it takes? I can see it written on your face. You've seen me make every mask I create to keep you out till it's just too late. I've made a mess like I've never cleaned before. I don't wanna see you crying anymore. I don't wanna see you crying anymore. I don't wanna see you crying anymore.
Yeah, lovely.
Those are fantastic. Megan, that music video was edited in a really fun way. It was really cool to watch. And then, of course, the Dinermans. We always love them. The trumpet really added things to it, too.
Yeah.
Good work.
Alrighty, folks. I think that is the end of our night. But don't go anywhere yet, because we have our credits. And with a special hidden gift that is from the teachers who may or may not be monkeying around. So I just wanted to first of all say thank you so much again for sticking around with all the technical difficulties and stuff. We had so many wonderful performers, and I'm so happy that we could spend time with all you guys and all the wonderful comments you made and everything. Thank you for all the submissions. Thank you for the teacher moderators, all the MCs and stuff. We did it. We got through the night. Now we just have to do the credits. So thank you again. We're going to have more events coming up soon that will be live streamed as well. I'm not going to be doing the live streaming this time, so maybe there'll be less mistakes. But stay tuned for that. And also, check all the links in the description below. Submit some photos if you have any. Give us your feedback. Tell me what we did. Tell me what I did wrong. Because any feedback is helpful. Is there anything you guys would like to say?
There's a no disclaimer rule.
Anything you'd like to say? Any goodbyes or farewells? This is the last screen is yours.
I'm going to miss being amazing show.
This is our last word for all of us, I feel like, low-key.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to be coming back for sure. I'm going to come back and see some.
I'll come back too. I just can't perform.
Because Megan will be at BC, but she'll be with us.
This is my last word.
Bye, Megan. See you later. Okay. I think it's time for us to play the credits, unless you want to say anything else.
I think we're good.
Okay, thank you again, guys. We're going to cue the credits and mute our mics. It's been so much fun. Please enjoy this video of the teachers dancing to Dr. Orangutan by the Sitters and the Makers. It's going to be freaking epic. I hope it works. Here we go. Sorry, technical difficulties, everybody. I had it set up and it was working, and now it's not, but stick around. This is really important, and you're not going to want to miss this one, because it's one of the best acts, if not the greatest act of all time, if I may say so myself. So please stick around. I got to find the right video, because there's way too many videos. Stick around. Where is it? Final videos. Aha, credits. That's the one. I found it. There it is. Let's watch it. There we go.
He's coming into town.
Thank you guys.
He'll take that frown and turn it right round upside down. Why don't you meet and greet 233 down Glasgow Street? Be the monkey and the trunkie out of junky old Oldsmobile. He's got that bag of tricks, his lollipops and slapping sticks, his tongue antidepressor's got you up. Some say he'll never think pharmaceutical notes in invisible ink, and when he smiles there, while you might see behind the tube. Doctor Orangutan, he's cured away all your blues. He's got a paper slips with clever quips and a step to put in your shoes. Doctor Orangutan, did you hear the news? He got his PhD in comedy at the Central Park Zoo. Stethoscopes, but can he feel the rain? How it looks for set respect, his honesty becomes regret. Though he may well be society, he's still not human yet. Dr. Orangutan is cured away out of blues. His man of fear will make you squeal in his 9.5-foot shoes. Dr. Orangutan, can he sing the blues? He got his doctorate in dark chocolate at the NYCCU. Dr. Orangutan tastes sweetness on his tongue. Despite his woes, his friends will know he feels beyond the sun. Dr. Orangutan, you'll never see him frown. He'll learn to hold his fellow primate up out of spite for feeling down. Dr. Orangutan, he's cured away all his blues. He's got a paper slips with clever grips and a step to put in your shoes. Dr. Orangutan, did you hear the news? He got his undergrad in being glad on the 472. He got his doctorate in dark chocolate at the NYCCU. He got his PhD in a comedy at the Central Park Zoo.
I'm so sorry.